Hi, I'm Regan Pearson, and today I will be reading you The Greedy Triangle by Marilyn Burton. Once, there was a triangle that was, as most triangles are, always busy. The triangle spent its time holding up roofs, supporting bridges, making music in symphony orchestras, catching the wind for sailboats, being slices of pie and halves of sandwiches, and much, much more. The triangle's favorite thing, however, was to slip into place when people put their hands on their hips. That way, I always hear the latest news, it said, which I can tell my friends. The triangle's friends liked hearing the news. One day, the triangle began to feel dissatisfied and tired of doing the same old things, it grumbled. There must be more to life. So, the triangle went to see the local shapeshifter. How may I help you? The shapeshifter asked the triangle. I think if I had just one more side and one more angle, said the triangle, my life would be more interesting. That's easy to do, said the shapeshifter. Poof! The shapeshifter turned the triangle into a quadrilateral. Life changed in a wonderful way. The quadrilateral was happy with all new things it could do. The quadrilateral could be a baseball diamond, or first, second, or third base. It could be a position on a checkered board or a chessboard. It could be a television screen, a computer screen, or a movie screen. It could frame windows or frame pictures and much, much more. The quadrilateral's favorite thing, however, was to be the pages on the book. And I learned so many interesting stories that way, it said, which I can tell my friends. The quadrilateral's friends liked hearing the stories. But one day, the quadrilateral began to feel dissatisfied. I'm tired of doing the same old things, it grumbled. There must be more to life. How may I help you now? The shapeshifter asked the quadrilateral. I think if I had just one more side and one more angle, said the shape quadrilateral, my life would be more interesting. That's easy to do, said the shapeshifter. Poof! The shapeshifter turned the quadrilateral into a pentagon. Life changed in a wonderful way. The pentagon was happy with all the new things it could do. On a baseball diamond, the pentagon could be home plate. It could be a section on a soccer ball or appear inside whenever someone drew a five-pointed star. The pentagon's favorite thing, however, was to be the headquarters of the United States military near Washington, D.C. I hear all the top secrets that way, it said. It's too bad I can't tell any of my friends. The Pentagon's friends couldn't help feel left out. After a while, this seemed to pass slowly for the Pentagon, and it became dissatisfied. I'm tired of doing the same old things, it grumbled. There must be more to life, so the Pentagon went back to the shapeshifter. So you're here again, the shapeshifter said to the Pentagon. Now what would you like? I think if I had just one more side and one more angle, said the Pentagon, my life would be more interesting. That's easy to do, said the shapeshifter. Poof! The shapeshifter turned the Pentagon into a hexagon. Life changed again in a wonderful way. The hexagon was happy with all the new things it could do. The hexagon fit in as the floor tiles of the house and patios and fancy crackers at parties and picnics. It worked as the socket of certain bolts and prongs and certain wrenches. The hexagon's favorite thing, however, was to be a cell in a beehive. I love watching the bees as they buzz in and out, said the hexagon. He spent so much time in the beehive, it was too busy to talk to his friends. The friends missed the hexagon and couldn't help feeling ignored. Again and again, the shape became restless, dissatisfied, and unhappy with its life. Again and again, it returned to the shapeshifter for more sides and more angles. The shapeshifter agreed to turn into one shape after another, a heptagon, an octagon, a nonagon, a decagon, and on and on and on. Finally, the shape had many, many sides and many, many angles. Its sides were so small, it had trouble keeping its balance. Its friends couldn't tell which side it was on and began to avoid the shape. One day, the shape was going down a hill. It began to roll. Faster and faster it went, screeching around corners, crashing into fences and trees, colliding with bicycles and terrifying walkers. At last, the shape came to a stop. It felt tired and dizzy, lonely and sad. Enough, thought the shape. I don't know which side is up. I can't balance. My friends don't want to be around me. The shape could no longer remember why it had been so unhappy as a triangle. Very carefully, it made its way back to the shapeshifter. Aren't you happy yet? The shapeshifter asked. I want to be a triangle again, said the shape. I'm not surprised, said the shapeshifter. Poof! The shapeshifter turned the shape back into a triangle. The triangle was delighted to have its old shape back again and keep itself very busy. Once again, it held up roofs, supported bridges, made music in a symphony orchestra, caught the wind for sailboats, became slices of pie and halves of sandwiches, and much, much more. Still, the triangle's favorite thing was to slip into the place where people put their hands on their hips. That way, I always hear the latest news, it said, which I can tell my friends. Its friends liked hearing the news and were glad that the triangle was back in shape again. Even before school, children are often exposed to shapes, either directly or indirectly. As seen in this video, shapes are added to the triangle to transform it into a new one. This allows for the students to visualize the shapes in a larger and smaller picture. Many variations and extensions can be added to this lesson. Burns even includes some in the back of her book. Thanks for watching.